Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to configure incremental refresh against your Power BI dataset. You don't have access to the PBIX file. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Okay, someone asked on our live stream, hey, I don't have access to my PBIX file anymore. Maybe they enable large models. Maybe they've interacted with the model via the XMLA endpoint, so they can't download the PBIX file and they don't have the original and they want to configure incremental refresh. How do you do it? Well, that's what I'm going to show you in this video. There's a doc out there on the Tabular Editor site where they walk you through this. I decided to do a video anyway, because some people like to watch video. Also, you will need premium or premium per user, because everything we're going to do is via the XMLA endpoint. All right, kind of laid the foundation there. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So you can use Tabular Editor 2 or Tabular Editor 3. I'm using Tabular Editor 3. I mean, you'll see towards the end where there's a difference in how you set it up, but stay tuned to the end, I'll show you. So the first thing you need to do is get connected to your model in your workspace. Click on the load model from database icon, pop in your XMLA endpoint, click okay, and get authenticated. Once you're authenticated, you can choose the database. I'm already connected to my model here in the Power BI desktop. So the first thing you need to do is create your range start and range end parameters. To do that, you're going to create shared expressions. Open the Tom Explorer, right click on shared expressions and choose create and choose shared expressions. We're going to give them some names. These are synonymous with the parameters that you would create when you're setting up incremental refresh in the desktop. You have to give those the exact same name. Then what you do is you need to go write the code for these parameters. I kid, you don't have to write this all the way out. Let me show you something. Go over to Power BI desktop, go into the query editor and actually create these parameters. You can go manage parameters and create them. You see, I've created my range start and my range end. Once you see them there, go here, choose advanced editor and you'll see the code. So you could just copy and paste it. You guys know how I am. I'm not lazy, I'm just efficient. And this is much more efficient than writing all this code out. Just paste it and then go over to range end and paste the exact same code. You just want to change the date. If I was setting this up in the desktop, I would just load data for November 2021 because you can see I'm going 11/1/2021 to 11/30/2021. So that's all I've done. The next thing is you need to set the kind, it's a property for each one of these shared expressions to M. If I click the drop down, you see it's M, and do the same thing for range start. We're rocking and rolling. The next thing you want to do in the Tom Explorer is expand out tables and select the table that you want to set up incremental refresh for. And then in the properties window, you'll see here at the top, there's a refresh policy section. You need to enable the refresh policy property. So just switch it from false to true, and then you're going to see all these properties light up. So the first one you want to set is incremental granularity, and we're going to change that because we only want to refresh the current year and then specify one for the incremental period. So 2021, when we roll to the next window, we're going to refresh that window. You want to go here, the rolling window granularity. So we're going to say years. This is where we specify how many years, days, and month we want to actually keep in my model. In our case, we want to keep 10 years. The other properties, a little beyond the scope, maybe I'll come and do a video on those, but you definitely can set up the polling expression and full period and stuff here too. The final thing you want to do is specify the source expression. It's the expression that's actually the M that's going to pull data from your model for this particular table. Right here, I've added a filter rows line to filter out the data using that range start and range end. You can freehand this or you can simply go over to the desktop and, you know, generate some code and just copy and paste it back. Just make sure you test it out to ensure that it works. All right. So now I have everything set up. All I need to do is save my model. So I'm going to go here, save changes back to the database. And this is where Tabular Editor 2 and Tabular Editor 3 kind of go down two different paths. Check out Tabular Editor 2. When I'm all done with everything, I can right click and choose apply refresh policy. And it's going to create all my partitions for me. In Tabular Editor 3, if I right click, I don't get that option. And so I actually emailed Daniel, the creator of Tabular Editor, and he said, oh, not quite there yet. It's coming, but here's a script. And you can use that to simulate exactly what you do in Tabular Editor 2. Let me show you. I created a C# script. And I wrote a little line of code. Let me show you what the code looks like. So I have a macro that I created. created. And you can see right here, selected, dot table, dot apply refresh policy. That's pretty much what that button does on the other side. So I created that macro with this little snippet of code, and then I created a button. If you don't know how to create this button, I have a video out there that shows you how to create that button. So you can reuse this in all your subsequent models where you need to apply incremental refresh, at least until Daniel adds that button in the context menu of the table. I'm gonna go back to my Time Explorer. Here's my internet sales table. I'm gonna click my apply refresh button here, and then we're gonna look at our partitions, and you can see all my partitions are created. This is great. So instinctively, I wanna head over to the service, go find my data set, everything set up so that the refresh would succeed. So I'm gonna click refresh. And what I'm gonna do is head over to Management Studio. I'm gonna refresh this, and then I'm gonna go over to my partitions and see what's going on. You can see that only one of those partitions refreshed. This model has been out in the service. It's been refreshed several times. If this was the first time, it would have refreshed every partitions. But Power BI said, hey, you've already refreshed this, so I'm just gonna adhere to your incremental refresh policies and only refresh the current year. So how do I refresh the other ones? I've got tons of videos on how you can hydrate individual partitions using XMLA scripts, using SQL Server Management Studio, but I wanna show you a little something that's available in Tabular Editor where you can do this also there. Here's all of my partitions, and I can right click on them and say refresh full partition. Head over to the data refresh, and you can say, hey, it's refreshing three partitions. I could have done all of them. It's completely up to me. I could refresh the entire table, but after this is finished, I can head back over to Management Studio and I can see that those three partitions are refreshed. Let me show you. So now back in Management Studio, if I just click refresh here, you can see that those three partitions are refreshed, and you can continue to refresh them, or you can just refresh the whole table. It's up to you. There's lots of different ways to get all that data refreshed. But once you go back to Power BI and click refresh, it's just gonna refresh the current year. It's just gonna adhere to your refresh policy that you've just set up in Tabular Editor. All right, what do you guys think? You got any questions, comments? If you've done this before, if you run into challenges before, I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting a guy in the Cube channel, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button. You like my video, your big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.